And I am a astronomer. I'm Mike Brown. I'm a professor of planetary astronomy at Caltech. I study anything you can do in the solar system with telescopes, mostly the outer solar system. I find Europa one of the most fun bodies in the solar system, in the sense that if you were just looking around the solar system, looking for an object that was interesting in some way, and in the way that you might think of it as interesting is interesting in the sense that it has a lot of liquid water. You would look at the Earth, you would say, yep, a lot of water there, that's pretty cool. The next place you would look for liquid water would be Europa. It has the most amount of accessible liquid water anywhere in the solar system. And so it has to be an interesting place simply by virtue of having that liquid water. And one of the things I'm most interested in is trying to understand what else is inside that ocean besides just water. What's the chemical composition of the salts in that ocean? And understanding that composition leads you to understand things like if the conditions are the types of conditions that might be conducive to life. I'm not going to say they tell you whether there's life there or not, but I'll tell you that it's the sort of things that tells you if it's chemically rich things that life would enjoy or if it's a kind of sterile environment. And we've been learning about the composition of the ocean by looking at the surface of Europa, where in cracks or geysers, in some way, the ocean gets up onto the surface, the water evaporates, and the salts are left out on the surface. So we've been studying those salts to understand what's there. Exploring underneath the ice of Europa is hard. One of the nice early steps would be that you can actually just land on the surface and the surface has stuff from the ocean, so you could just scrape off the surface and you know, take a taste of it and see what the ocean is like. But if you really wanted to get down below and swim around in the ocean, and who wouldn't? The proposed missions, the only one that I've heard that seems even semi-viable is you land on the surface with basically a big nuclear pile, and you melt your way down through the ice, and eventually you get down into the water, and then you set your robotic submarine free, and it goes around and swims with the big Europa whales. It's hard to imagine that you could find anything, even in a chemical signature inside the ocean, that would really push the idea that there must be life in there that's making it happen. And the reason that it would be hard to find something that would make it so obvious is that we know so little about the core composition of Europa and its interaction with the seawater. And many different things could be going on leading to all sorts of disequilibrium chemistries. And that's sort of always what you're looking for, is chemical species that shouldn't be there if everything was just in regular equilibrium. And there are so many reasons why you might have it on Europa. You have interactions with the core, you have a strong radiation environment. So it would be very difficult, I think, to come up with a really sound chemical fingerprint that life must exist there.
Thanks for watching. Now make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're into what we're doing and you want to see extra behind the scenes content, like the full length raw interviews, you can join our community by clicking this link here.